welcome you to our science demonstration today. We're doing science that is fun, that has a purpose. And today our demonstration is called PVA plus B equals limes. Now, we're going to make a lime today, and we're going to do this in a fun way. And I have an assistant who's going to help me here today. We hope to have another assistant, but that assistant didn't make it yet. But what we have here are some things that we're going to need for this process. We're going to need a bowl and a spoon. You can use a disposable bowl, a plastic spoon if you want. I've used these clear ones so we can see a little better in them, and we may have to clean them out, but it won't be so hard. We'll need some water. We'll need maybe some measuring cups. We need some glue, something like Elmer's white glue, some food coloring if you wish. And we have a solution here of borax, water with some borax mixed in it. Not too much, but it tells you the proportions there on our thing. And what we're going to do, we're going to start with the glue. And so actually I'd like for you to pour, take the top off that, and we're going to pour the whole bottle of glue in the bowls. Okay? So just go ahead and pour away. We'll get this glue out of here. It takes a little bit of plopping to get it out. Can you just imagine all the good cleanup that we're going to have from this? Won't that be a lot of fun? So we get all this good glue out. Okay, that's pretty much the glue there from that one. And she's getting every last drop out. Okay, that's enough. Now what we're going to do, we're going to mix some water in our glue, and we're going to thin it down a little bit. And depending on how juicy we want our lime to be, we're going to add water. Now, we can either add a half a cup of water, a third cup, or maybe a fourth cup, or even a few tablespoons. So what do you think you'd like to make your lime, juicy or not? How do you want?
A third.
She wants a third cup. Okay, you can have a third. I'm going to take a fourth. And what we're going to do, we're going to pour some water. Here you go. Into our little measuring device. And put that into your glue. And now take your spoon and stir, stir, stir. And we're going to thin this glue down a little bit. It's water-soluble glue, so it will thin if we just stir it around a little bit. It's important to do. You see? And then, because you're going to make a lime, we're going to put green food coloring in it. Okay? But I think I'd like to make a lemon. So I'm going to use some yellow food coloring in mine.
How many drops?
Oh, I don't know. However much you want. Just enough to make it good and colored. 7-8 drops is enough, maybe. And boy, I got some good yellow coming in here now. Stir it up till it looks pretty good. Nice and smooth. This glue actually has something called polyvinyl acetate in it. Polyvinyl acetate, and that's PVA. And to this PVA, we're going to add some borax. And if we go to the next slide, it tells you a little bit of the procedure there and what you're going to do and how to do it. And it tells us there how much borax to add. It just says a little bit. And I'm going to take my spoon here, and I'm going to pour about a tablespoon of water, of this borax solution, on here. And then I'm going to start stirring this into my solution here. And we're going to see what happens here in about 30 seconds. This is going to start to solidify and make a lime, a big lime too.
How do you make an orange or lemon?
A lemon. Yeah, you're making the lime. Okay, that's right. Now, depending on how much water you add, you can have a thicker or a thinner, juicier lemon or lime. And what we have here is, well, let's just put a little more in. Okay. Try that and stir real good. And so what we have now here is something we can pick up. And it's sort of slimy.
Yeah.
In fact, they call this slime. And slime is simply limes with the S moved to the front. Did you know that? And if you would go over on the desk, Sister Annika, and get me that little green thing.
Mine still isn't solidifying.
It didn't solidify enough. You maybe put too much water in it. if you put too much water in, it gets too thin. But what we have here is a piece that we made yesterday, and you can take this, and because this one's pretty solid, it didn't have as much water in it, you can squeeze it and make a lime out of it. See, it's like a little round lime. I need a tissue there. Thank you very much for that. What we can have is just a little more borax here, and the borax will actually help solidify and get this off of us.
Maybe we should add more borax.
Well, you would have to have more glue at this point. But this is one that we made yesterday, and don't try to wipe it too much with a towel. But you can see it makes a ball, a lime ball. This was a lemon, and you see it's pretty tough. But this is a polymer, and polymers have unique properties. And these are made up of chains of molecules. We know that in a solid object, the molecules are held very tightly. In a liquid, they're held very loosely. And that's why in a liquid, the water, if I was to take this water and pour it onto the table, it would just run out and splatter. Whereas if you have a solid, it doesn't. But if I was to take this polymer, or this one here, especially because it's more fluidy, and if I was to pour it into a container, a shaped container, this would very slowly form to the shape of the container because it will pour very slowly, like a glacier. As a glacier moves down a hill slowly. And in fact, we have a video. If we could go over to the video, it's called Speed. You see how it's going down slowly? This is over about 9 seconds of speed time photography. But actually, that video, and we'll run it again, this video took place over a 4-minute period. 4 minutes for this of itself to flatten out. And in fact, if we'd left the camera on longer, it would have got, and in fact, it did get even flatter. But there's a lesson that we want to learn from this. These polymer chains, yeah, if you have them like that, you notice that, and this one's getting a little more solid here too, but you can take these and you can pull them and stretch them very slowly. Like I say, they'll pour even. And if you took a book, like if I had my Strong's Concordance, which is a pretty big book, or my Young's right over there on the shelf, which is a big book, Young's, it's right there in front of you, that's this. Uh-huh. If we took this and we lay it on the table here, I'll wipe the water away up from it here. And we put this on top. The weight of this is going to smash it down. And I'm going to just give it a little extra push here to speed up the process. Thanks to Young's Concordance, we now have a piece of flat lime. It's flattened out. See, feel how smooth it is. Mm-hmm. Now, if I take this and want to stretch it, if I do this slowly with constant pressure, you could actually stretch this out to be thinner than paper, just very, very, very thin.
And it's like silly putty.
It is. It's like a silly putty. Silly putty is one of these kind of polymers. But you know what happens? If I do like that, it just breaks apart instantly. And if we go to our next slide in our other file, there's a lesson that we want to learn from that. These polymer chains hold these molecules together. And in our lives, we have chains of sin that hold us and bind us. And sometimes people think the best way to get rid of sin is to just slowly take a little bit at a time, remove a little bit at a time. Maybe if I'm smoking, for instance, I have a habit of smoking. If I just start cutting back on my cigarettes a little each day, I'll eventually quit. But what happens is, when you keep doing just a little bit at a time, you're still bound together. You're still chained to that problem. The best way to get rid of sin, and the only effective way to get rid of sin, is to ask Jesus to come into our heart and make an immediate break with that sin, to deny it and to choose to do what is right immediately and not wait and try to stretch out our overcoming. It doesn't work like that. We break immediately and it goes. And by the way, if you make this, you can take it and you can squeeze it slowly because it forms, it flows back together and make a nice little ball out of it. And in this one here, this one's actually getting a little more solid as it's set here a little bit longer. It's still pretty slimy, but Ashley wants to play with it. So there she has. So if you ever drop some glue, just remember one of the best ways to clean it up is to get some borax, because the borax will turn it into slime. Slime is limes with the S moved in front. And that's what we have here today. We have some slime, but it's nice slime, isn't it? Isn't that beautiful, gooey slime? But remember this, that the lesson we want to learn is that when we try to pull away from sin, if we don't make a clean break, it doesn't come apart. Thank you for being with us. Until next time, may God bless you lots and lots. Bye-bye.